In this program, Don discusses being a child of God, and answers some listeners' questions on healing. He also tells about applying the Word of God to receive his healing from an aneurysm. Let's listen.
This is Don Gossett. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord.
Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. So we're told in Matthew 24, verse 35. Welcome to Bold Bible Living with Don Gossett, teaching Bible principles as timely today as they were yesterday. And now, from the radio library of Bold Bible Living, ready to bless us with his life-changing message, pastor and world evangelist, Don Gossett.
Thank you, Mike Odell. I'm continuing to share with you about the wonder of being a child of God and not being ashamed of Jesus Christ as your own Lord and Savior. I recall a time when I dedicated my life fully to the Lord. I was just a teenager. Let me see, I was about 18. I had just the year before received a call to prepare for ministry. But I had a job. I worked in a plant. And one of the first verses I memorized at the beginning of my Christian life was Romans 1:16, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it's the power of God and the salvation to everyone that believes." Over and over, I would quote this verse until I was assured that regardless whoever I encountered in my daily activities, I'd not be ashamed of Jesus. How could I ever be ashamed of him who bought me with his own blood? One of the real testings along this line was being brave enough to bow my head to ask the blessing before I ate my lunch. I worked with hard, sinful men, and I feared their scorn and ridicule. But little by little, I developed courage from confessing Romans 1:16, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it's the power of God and the salvation to everyone that believes." And again, I would then make a determination that I was going to thank God for my food, and I would bow my head and just with that determination. Now, I went through a little procedure. I would rub my eyes so no one would know what I was doing when I was saying my little prayer. And then I would perhaps select a time to ask the blessing when no one else is looking. But I discovered that if I kept delaying, my food would get cold if it were warm, and too often I was finding myself frustrated, so I persisted. And finally, it became a real victory in my life when I began to make a regular and precious habit to simply thank my Lord for the food, whether it was on the job or in a restaurant or anywhere. Now, I wasn't trying to be a holier-than-thou guy. I wasn't trying to have a smug attitude that I was somebody special, but I just wanted to have victory in this matter, to learn how to deal not only with the bowing my head to thank God for the food, but I learned how to deal with the dirty jokes being told in my presence. Now, no genuine Christian wants to manifest a smug, holier-than-thou attitude, but neither do we want to permit our ears to be a garbage can. Let me say that again. As Christians, we don't want to manifest a holier-than-thou attitude that's so smug and religious. Nor do we want our ears, however, to be a garbage can for filthy stories from vulgar minds and mouths. Thank God the Lord gave me grace and ability to overcome in this matter too. And when the Bible says we are to endure hardness as good soldiers of Jesus Christ, this is maybe for many of you, as it was for me, a hardship to learn to stand up for the Lord, as it were, to be a simple Christian, not to be to preach at anybody or not to point fingers at anybody else, but to simply receive the grace of God to abound toward my life, that I could abound to every good work, Paul called it. All grace, he said, I give you. This includes grace to make us unashamed of the Lord and the good and holy standards set forth in God's Word. So you can begin to say it, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. And again, you can say it, Christ died for me, and I'll gladly confess him before others. So what a joy it is to have faith in God and to obey his Word. Now, before I have time today to have a prayer of faith for you that are sick, let me just challenge you to begin to take your bold rights in Christ. Over and over, I've emphasized what you can do through Christ who indwells you, that you can say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Thank God this dynamic message works. One man who had been a man-fearer and consequently a man-pleaser, instead of a Christ pleaser, took to heart this powerful truth of authority that I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. He ministered to a lady who had very bad eyes. Her glasses she wore were thick and heavy lenses. However, this believer knew the authority of the name of Jesus, and he had faith in his own faith to minister to this woman. He commanded the spirits of infirmity to depart from her eyes and for the sight to be strengthened. Notice here, anyone whom God uses to produce supernatural results knows the importance of the word of authority. This believer commanded the sight to be strengthened. Thanks be to God, the spirit of infirmity was driven out, and healing virtue flowed into those eyes. This lady began to see well without her glasses. Now I want to pause a moment to emphasize there are two vital steps to take to help minister healing to the sick, and that is the spirit of infirmity to be driven out and for healing virtue to flow in. These two factors are very important. Now, this lady had previously been denied a driver's license because of her poor sight. However, after receiving her healing, she returned to the office of the driver's examiners and requested a new test. The examiner, knowing this was the same woman who had previously failed the eye test, even with glasses, was so amazed that the woman could see without glasses and pass the test. He thought there must be some irregularity, and before he would consent to give her a license, he demanded a report from an eye specialist. Well, the examination was made and the report given. And this woman had good, strong sight. She got her driver's license. This miracle happened because the believer had faith in his own faith to minister healing to this woman, and the Lord made her whole. So I say to you, believer, be bold in taking your rights in Christ. Now, incidentally, I've referred in the third person to a believer that exercises authority. And that believer happens to be your minister of this broadcast, Don Gossett. And the lady who received the miraculous healing for her infirm eyes was a lady named Mrs. William Vandeveen. When I ministered to her, she lived at Lake Cowichan, but then she moved to Parkside, Saskatchewan. And I met her years later in Prince Albert, where she shared with me how that healing was still valid, that she still had good sight because the Lord had honored his word. So now I want to minister to you. I want to take authority in the name of Jesus for the spirit of infirmity in your body to be driven out and for healing virtue to flow into your body. Father, I thank you for what your promise is. And today I speak your word of deliverance. I take authority over spirits of infirmity, of cancer, high blood pressure, heart trouble, arthritis, for spirits of infirmity upon eyesight, upon hearing, upon the afflicted limbs. In Jesus' name, I rebuke the spirits of infirmity for them to be driven out of these bodies in Jesus' mighty name. And now, Lord, for your healing virtue to flow in by the Holy Spirit, this healing virtue to be manifest today. And I say thank you, Lord, for this in the name of Jesus. Thank God for the blessing of the Lord and for God's grace that's ours today. And for you that need the Lord to minister to you a total deliverance, I want to help you today to receive from him. Now, I've had some questions that I want to answer right here. The one this lady writes, "Dear Don, I've been prayed for, but somehow the old symptoms of my affliction have returned. And I want to say to you, recognize this as a device of the devil, a trick of Satan. And you can overcome this device by the blood of the Lamb, the word of your testimony. Apply the blood of Jesus. Speak that word about the name of Jesus, about the word of the Lord, and you can see the Lord's deliverance." Another question I have, why is it that some faithful Christians are not healed? Well, of course, I don't have all the answers why some Christians are healed and some are not. I certainly don't have that answer. And I've worked with many men and women who have great ministries in this area who do not have the answers either, but we keep on taking God at his word. But however, basically, I would say that if you, as a faithful Christian, have not really been healed, it may be because you haven't discovered that healing is your rightful privilege through the atoning work of Jesus, or else you fail to act on his word for your healing. It's plainly a matter of either ignorance of the truth or disobedience on your part. Now, another question I have, is it important to pray and fast before coming for healing? Well, there's no merit on our part to earn our healing. It's simply by the grace of a loving God. However, fasting and prayer are very profitable and they're ordained of God. Fasting is simply a detachment from the things of time and senses, whether it be fasting from food, pleasure, or physical ambition. Prayer is an attachment to the things of God. Yes, prayer and fasting are important. And another question I have, do you have to be a Christian to be healed? Well, the majority of the healings in the book of Acts were healings of sick people who had not yet become Christians. However, Jesus Christ called healing the children's bread and is truly the heritage of every born-again believer. The salvation of your eternal soul is far more important than the healing of your body, but both are provided for in the atonement of Jesus Christ. And you, one more question I have here. Don, what is the greatest secret you consider to healing and health? Well, Jesus often said to those whom to me ministered, "Thy faith hath made thee whole." Since the Bible declares that faith is our victory, here's a secret that I have discovered. The language of faith is praise and thanksgiving to the Lord. Praising people are often the most joyful and healthiest people this side of heaven. I know when I received the verdict in about the year 2003 that I had an aneurysm in my body, the ultrasound had revealed. And the doctor asked me, "Do you understand what an aneurysm is?" I said, "I may not know scientifically, but I know my own father had an aneurysm. And when it burst, he was dead in just a few hours." He said, "Well, you have this aneurysm, and I'm scheduling you for a CAT scan." And he looked at his calendar and said, "You'll have the CAT scan in 6 weeks. My wife, Deborah, and I began to speak the word of the Lord. I have this alphabet of healing that's been a faith builder to many people. And we began to speak those 26 healing scriptures every day with a whole heart and with a sense of expectation of God watching over his word to perform it. And when I had the CAT scan, then a few days later, I met the doctor again, and he looked at me with a nice smile and said, "Don, you have no more aneurysm. It's gone." Now, there was no medical treatment, no surgery, no medication or anything. It was simply 6 weeks of speaking the healing word of the Lord. And I want to assure you the same God can minister to you. So let's take him at his word. Father, I thank you. I thank you for your benefits. And I mean those benefits are healing for our bodies. And I pray you'll minister to those who have cancer, diabetes, heart trouble, high blood pressure. You minister to those who have arthritis and those who have growths. I pray in Jesus' name, your healing virtue to flow in to make whole. Amen. Join me as we praise the Lord together. Praise you, Lord. 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 Hallelujah.
From the Radio Library of Bold Bible Living with Don Gossett, Biblical Principles to a Dynamic Spiritual Life. God's truth does not change. Your prayers and love gift to Bold Bible Missions is your way to partner with us in winning the lost for Christ. Send your letters of support to Bold Bible Missions in Canada, Box 75120, White Rock, British Columbia, V4A OB1, or Box 2, Blaine, Washington, 98231. Your love gift to Bold Bible Missions is your way to partner with us in winning the lost for Christ. Please send your prayer request, your praise reports, and letters of support in Canada, Box 75120, White Rock, British Columbia, V4A OB1, or Box 2, Blaine, Washington, 98231. And from all of us here at Bold Bible Missions, thank you. I was there.